Bastianini. It's the beast that wins a classic on the last lap again. And Andrea Bastianini surely on course for a famous victory. On the grid here in Austin, the red lights will come on very, very shortly, as it's soon going to be time to tame the horsepower rodeo. Who's going to be our king of COTA in 2022?
Bastianini is coming past Francesco Bagnaia. Bastianini already up into third.
Watch this. Andrea Bastianini's GP21 just streaks away down this 1,200 metre back straight.
Bastianini on Marti.
Ladies and gentlemen, who is the fastest man on the circuit?
Bastianini saw that lap from Jack Miller, that personal best the previous time round, and he's immediately responded. Look at the gap. It's already down to 0.3 of a second in the first sector alone.
He sat behind the Australian now for a good 5 or 6 laps. He's worked out exactly where the Australian's weak points are. When will Andrea Bastianini pick his moment? Here comes the move on the inside, using the slipstream. Andrea Bastianini then leads. He hits the front at turn 12 for the first time. 4.5 laps to go. Andrea Bastianini, all hail the new King of COTA in 2022. Australia, we are go.
A word on Andrea Bastianini, the other title contender. It's been a nightmare start for him. He's outside of the top 18 now. I think he's 20th at the moment.
It looks like we're going to lose one of our 5 title contenders at the end of play today, because Andrea Bastianini is having a horror show here in Phillip Island. Outside the points right now, down in 17th place. And the beast started to come back into top 6 contention. Maybe better as well. We know how good Bastianini is at conserving rear tyres for the end of the Grand Prix. He's in 10th place.
Andrea Bastianini back in 9th position, did a 1:30.053. We know how good he is at managing that rear tyre. He is on the harder rear tyre, and whisper it quietly, he's only 1.6 seconds off the lead. But Andrea Bastianini piled up the inside of Brad Binder and forced in wide, so Bastianini is beginning his charge. He's now up into 8th. He'll be up behind Aleix Espargaró. Bastianini through on Aleix Espargaró. Bastianini is right on the back of this group now.
Here comes Alex Rinso, a tight inside line again. Out of shape goes Marc Marquez in that Repsol Honda. Rins stands firm.
I have lose a little bit there here, and it explodes my airbag, and I make 1.5 laps with this open, and I have lose a lot of position.
The French Grand Prix in 2022 is on the way. It's a great start by the two factory Ducatis from the front row. They launch off the line. The shoulder cam gives us a perfect view of the start for Aleix Espargaró, who's going to be aggressive up the inside here. Alex Rins had a superb start. He's up the inside of the Dunlop chicane. And what about Bastianini? He's gone 5th into 2nd.
But you can see how close the beast is to the back of Jack Miller. Generally, when you've got Andrea Bastianini behind you, so close to the front of a Grand Prix, it's a matter of when rather than if the beast comes past you.
How much longer can Jack Miller keep Andrea Bastianini at bay? He's doing a great job here being wingman.
Oh,
here it comes. Nine laps to go then, and it is now a battle between Bagnaia and Bastianini. Oh, now it's played. And then Bastianini goes up the inside on the Grisini Ducati into the Dunlop chicane. He'll have that inside line. I don't think Bagnaia will get him on the cutback. It's all now about the drive over the hill through turn number 5. So Andrea Bastianini hits the front with 7 laps to go here.
Oh, he's
in a little bit wide though, isn't he? Through La Chapelle into turn number 6, having worked so hard to take the lead. Bagnaia's got it hot. Bagnaia's been pushed into a rare mistake. Well, he has buckled, he has cracked. We don't see that very often from Pekka Bagnaia. But on the brakes, then down into Garage Fair on lap number 21. Bagnaia. Is it Bagnaia? Pekka Bagnaia. Well, can you believe it?
What a miserable 20-second lap for Bagnaia.
Incredible. I can't believe it. We were just saying about how so good he is at handling the pressure, being so ice cool and so composed. And then the space of 5 corners, Pekka Bagnaia drops the ball twice. And now Bastianini wins the 2022 French Grand Prix. are on the final lap here in Motorland Aragon. Will it be Bagnaia or will it be Bastianini? We saw this thing between Bagnaia and Marquez 1 year ago. What can Andrea Bastianini do about Bagnaia ahead of him?
Is he going to pull off a sneak attack? Here he goes, into seven.
Into seven, he just squeezes Bagnaia out towards the paint. Now then, Pekka Bagnaia, how much risk will he take for those extra five World Championship points? Bastianini then hits the front on the final lap, going into turn number seven. He's sweep now out of the reverse corkscrew. Is Bagnaia going to go all in here for those extra five World Championship points for a historic fifth win in a row? They now wind up then towards turn number 12. This is one of the last overtaking places on this final lap. I don't think Bagnaia's going to be close enough. Can Bastianini get that Grazini Ducati stop? Yes, he can. So Bastianini then now, this has been his territory, this has been his domain all weekend. He's had the fastest motorcycle here in Aragon all weekend, and I don't think Bagnaia is going to be close enough. And now Bastianini just walked two corners away here from victory in a classic in Motorland Aragon. He gets a bit of a moment on that rear tyre. I don't think Bagnaia is going to catch him, or is he? Over the line they come. Is it going to be Bastianini or Bagnaia? It's the beast that wins a classic on the last lap again. It's lights out and lift off for MotoGP in 2022 in Qatar. Not a bad start for the pole man Jorge Martin, although big moment. The two reps, London's got away brilliantly. Marc Marquez gets the whole shot. Pol Espargaró slots into second. The initial launch good for Martin. Then he got in bog, big moment. But it's the two reps London's who lead. Can Andrea Bastianini's Ducati do anything about the Repsol Honda and Marc Marquez directly ahead of him? He's picked up some slipstream. He'll have the inside line and he eases by Marc Marquez on the brakes into the first corner.
Bastianini, who's Ducati's sole hope now at the front of this Grand Prix, looking as if he wants to make a bid immediately to get into second place. He can see that factory Honda of Espargaró going off into the distance.
There's nothing wrong with the top speed of the KTM, we know that. We saw it in Mugello last year, but Bastianini sweeps on through. Beast mode engaged yet again. He knew he had to make that move. He could see Pol Espargaró just starting to put a bit of daylight at the front. He runs a little bit wide. He cuts it back, chops Brad Binder's nose off as they swing through to turn two, but Bastianini gets the job done.
And Andrea Bastianini then pulls out of the slipstream straight past Pol Espargaró. Can Pol Espargaró get back past? Does he have any grip on the brakes to get past? No. Bastianini gets his stop to Pol Espargaró. In fact, runs wide into turn one.
That's game over for Pol Espargaró. He did that in one of the Grand Prix here last year.
Andrea Bastianini just needs to keep it smooth through turn 15 and only turn 16 to go for a hugely emotional victory and a historic occasion for the Beast.
Wow.
Binder's closing.
Binder is closing. Andrea Bastianini's got to be careful here. They come out of the final corner. Andrea Bastianini surely on course for a famous victory. The Beast reigns supreme in the Middle East. What an emotional victory for Andrea Bastianini and the Grazini Ducati team.
Hi, I'm Andrea Bastianini. If you enjoyed the video, hit like and subscribe.